in the last challenge, where we calculated the BMI, you saw how when we had a number that had a long list of numbers after the decimal point, for example, if I had divided 8 by 3, and I print this out, you'll see that the value is 2.666666. And if we had just turned this 8 divided by 3 into an integer, right now it's a floating point number, but if I convert it into an integer, you'll see that all it does is it just chops off everything after the decimal point, instead of what we would traditionally do, which is to round the number. So if it's 2.5, it would go to 3. If it's 2.4, it would go down to 2. Now, in Python, it's super easy to round numbers. All you have to do is to use the round function, like this. If we write round 8 divided by 3, then it's going to round it into a whole number. And you'll see that instead of 2, we actually get 3 now, because 2.6 recurring becomes 3. Now, if you wanted to, you can actually go a step further. You can specify the number of digits of precision you want to round it to. So if I said I want to round it to 2 decimal places, then I could write 8 divided by 3, comma, and then the number of places that I want to round it to. So now our 2.666 recurring becomes 2.67, because I said we should round it to 2 decimal places. So if it makes it easier, it might be easier if I write it like this. So 2.666666, and I'm going to round it to 2 decimal places, and again I get the same result, 2.67. Now, another way of modifying numbers is, instead of dividing, say, 8 divided by 3, we can also use the floor division, so where you have 2 forward slashes instead of just 1. Now, we know that whenever we divide any number by any other number, the result always gets turned into a floating point number. Now, if you didn't want that and you just wanted an integer, so a whole number chopping off all the numbers after the decimal place, you can just use the floor division like this. And in this case, you would get 2 straight away without having to convert it into an integer. And in fact, if I go ahead and check the data type of the result of this calculation, you'll see that it's actually an integer. Whereas if I had just used the single forward slash division, then I get a floating point number with decimal places, even if this is a clean division, say 4 divided by 2. This is still going to become a floating point number, and the number is going to be represented like this, 2.0, like so. Now, if we had saved the results of this calculation into a variable instead, then one of the things that you can actually do is to continue performing calculations on this variable. So for example, I could do 4 divided by 2, which is going to be equal to 2. But then if I want to divide it by, say, 2 again, I could actually say result divide equals 2. And when I now print result, I'll actually get 1, because it's 4 divided by 2, then divided by 2 again. Now, very often when you're writing code, say, for example, if you're keeping track of the user's score, so you could have score equals 0 to begin with, and every single time in your code, say a user scores a point, then you can get hold of this score variable again, and instead of saying score now equals the previous value of score plus 1, you can simply use this shorthand, plus equals. So plus equals 1. And now when we print score, you'll see that it's actually equal to 1. So instead of using plus equals, you can use minus equals, which just takes the previous version of score and removes 1 from it, multiply equals, and divide equals. So this is really handy when you have to manipulate a value based on its previous value, which you'll have to do a lot in programming. Now, the final thing I want to show you is something called f-strings. And this makes it really easy to mix strings and different data types. So far, up to this point, if we wanted to print something like your score is, and then we wanted to print the score, we have to write plus, but of course, because these are different data types, this is a string and this is an integer, we get a type error. So we've had to convert this into a string before it will actually successfully print when both the data types match. Now, this is quite painful, and understandably, a lot of programmers will need some slightly more convenient way of incorporating things that have different data types. Let's say the score is equal to 0, let's say their height is equal to 1.8, and is winning is equal to true. So here we've got an integer, a float, and a boolean, and we want to mix it all in to a sentence that is a string and get it printed out. So instead of having to convert all of these and use a whole bunch of plus signs, and then you have to convert everything into a string, it's really, really painful, right? So what we can do instead is use something in Python known as an f-string. And what an f-string allows us to do is, in front of a string like this one, we type the character f. And it's really important that it goes in front of the double quotes or single quotes if you want to write your strings like this. But I like to use double quotes, and a lot of other Python programmers do too. So essentially, you're adding just the character f in front of the string. And now this is an f-string. And you can start adding various values into this string. So for example, if I wanted to write your score is equal to this variable score, then I can put that variable inside a set of curly braces like this. And now when I print my string, this one right here, you'll see that it says your score is 0, and it does all of the converting and all of the stuff behind the scenes, and you don't have to worry about any of this. So if I want to continue along, I could say your score is this, your height is, add in the height, and then you are winning is, then let's add that final Boolean value and get it to run. You can see that our entire string now prints out, your score is 0, your height is 1.8, you are winning is true. So all of these different data types got combined into a string by using an F in front of the string, and then using these curly braces to place our variables into this string. By using F strings, you cut down on a lot of the manual labor of inserting different data types into a string. And this is going to come in really handy just about on the next lesson, where I've got a coding challenge for you. Head over there and complete the challenge.